Hi all, in this video lecture I am going to explain you about a timer B in an MSP 430. Okay, here it is a diagram of a timer B. I hope that everyone have gone through a timer A simplified block diagram. If you have gone through that one, just try to identify what is the main difference between a timer A and a timer B. Okay, let us try to look it in a timer block. Okay, in a timer block, in terms of a clock sources, everything as it is same, and in terms of a divider source, it is same. Now let us see in terms of a TBR, it is also a 16-bit timer register, and it has a timer B interrupt flag. Okay, as you all know that it is going to be generated when my counter goes to zero. There we had an MCX. Okay, here it has an extra bit CNTLX. Okay, this CNTLX is a 2-bit register. It is going to vary the register counter register size. Okay, this CNTLX bit is going to vary the timer counter register size into an 8 or an 10 or 12 or 16. It is by default. Okay, if you have not set the CNTLX bit, means simply it is going to work for a 16-bit counter. But if you change the CNTLX values, it is going to be choosing 8 or an 10 or an 12. Okay, that is the only difference we can see in this timer block. Now let us try to see in an capture compare channels. Okay, as you all know that capture compare channel can have a multiple. Okay, channel 0, channel 1, 2, based on the versions of a microcontroller we can have more. Now let us first try to see a capturing side. Okay, capturing side it is same. Then we have a capture mode CMX, it is also same. Earlier we had an CCI bit has been connected to SCCI bit through a latch. Okay, that connection we had, due to that connection we had a sampling mode, or we had an option to read the input signal value. Okay, that option is not available in this capture channel. That means simply I can tell that timer B doesn't support a sampling mode. Fine. Okay, I hope everyone are clear with this capturing part. Now let us try to see in this part. Earlier we had a capture mode TSCCRX to a comparator, but there is some additional block here. Okay, this additional block is an update mode. Okay, here we are going to write some value. That value is going to be updated into the TBCL. Okay, when it is going to update the TBCL value, it based on your CLLDX register. Okay, that is the main difference, you can see it. Okay, that means it is going to compare based on this TBCL, not on TBCCR1, but it is going to load the value. That value will be loaded to the TBCL based on this CLDX. Okay, that is nothing but here we have an one update mode. When it is going to update the value from this TBCCRX register. Okay, that is the thing. Then with respect to output, it is going to have an out B high. Okay, that means we can put all the output into an I impedance state straight away by setting the value. Earlier we don't had that option. Through an input we need to make that output an high. Okay, in order to recall what all the changes it has, in a timer block it has an CNTLX bits. It is going to make sure that the counter register size can be varied to an 8, 10 or an 12 or an 16. 16 is by default. Then in a capturing channel we cannot capture the input signal and it cannot be accessed. That's why sampling mode has been disabled. Then here it has an extra update mode. Okay, in this update mode it is going to take the value based on this CLDX, and the output modes can be made to an high. These are the main major four differences between timer A and timer B. Rest of all the operation is similar to your timer A. Please go through the timer A once again so that you can understand it very much clearly. Okay, the capture compare register TBCR are double buffered. Okay, that's what we have been seen here. Double buffered means earlier we are going to load, we are comparing straight away into memory. This is now it has been taking into this one. That's why it is called double buffered. The length of TBR can be programmed to 8, 10 or 12 or 16 bit by default. This is controlled by CNTLX bit. Okay. Range of bit selected for continuous mode as it is known. The SCCI bit is not provided, which means that sampling mode is not possible. Okay, go through our just previous lecture. You will be understanding how that sampling mode is going to be working. This means that timer B is less suitable for receiving an asynchronous signal, but timer A is always available if needed. Okay. Now timer B, if you are not able to receive an asynchronous signal, means definitely if any of the microcontroller having a timer B which doesn't have a timer A, means they will have a separate dedicated hardware for that particular asynchronous communication. It will be provided. Okay, in any case, the device that include timer B are likely to have a dedicated module for communication. Okay, that will be taken care. All of timer B outputs can be put into an high impedance state by high external signal applied to TB out H. Okay, if I write to this particular input pin, it's simply going to set all my outputs to an high state. Fine. This can be done in timer A only by using software to reconfigure the pins to an digital input. Okay, that is the difference what you have discussed in our previous block diagram. It has been highlighted. Okay, the latches are updated from TB CCRN at points in the cycle of an TBR controlled by CCLDX bits in TBCL. The four choices which are made independently for a chapter. Okay, based on that CCLDX bit, when it is going to take the value? Okay, that is simply this one. When it is going to be loaded, that's what we are trying to discuss there. Based on this CCLDX register. Okay, immediate mode means as soon as I am going to write the value to that TB CCR register, straight away it is going to be loaded into an TBCL register. Okay, that is nothing but an immediate mode. In TBR, when TBR counts to 0, at that time it is going to be getting loaded. My counter value whenever becomes in 0, that is going to get loaded. Then TBR counts to 0 if it is in an up mode or a continuous mode. Okay, in an up down mode, it is going to be updated whenever it is going to reach my older TBCL value, or TBR counts to n. In last one case, it is going to count. Okay. Here you can clearly see the operation. If it is 00, new data is transferred from TBCCRX to TBCLX immediately whenever TCRX is returned the value. If it is 01, the new data is transferred from TBCCRX to TBLX when TBR counts to 0. That means the earlier operations doesn't get affected until the completion. When the counter register comes to 0, then it will be get updated. Then if it is 10, new data is transferred to TBCCRX to TBLX when TBR counts to 0. When it is 0 for up and continuous mode. But if you are operating in an up down mode, at that time new data is transferred to TBRX TBLX when TBR counts to the old TBCL value. Okay, earlier your TBCL value was being set to and some 10. Suppose now you want to change it to and 20. Okay, that means dynamically you can change it. Okay, suppose don't take the 10 and 20. Suppose you take it 10 scenario, earlier TBCL value was 30. Now I want to update it to and 10, means before the completion, if I given 10, the previous task would have been not completed. Okay, it has to have been updated to 10, there the output have been changed. That's why in order to retain the old states properly, it is going to be counting until our previous value, what it has been loaded. Once it has been reached that particular point, it is going to get loaded with the new value. It makes sure that it is not going to miss anything. Then 11, in this state the new data is transferred whenever our TB CLX going to reach to the old value. Okay, this is what related to your timer B. In with respect to an timer selection or an division or an output modes or an compare mode, it is similar to your timer A. I hope everyone know that one. Okay, just you can replicate the same to an timer B. Now let us try to see what timers were. Okay, until now we have been discussed an watchdog timer, basic timer, real time clock, and then timer A and timer B. In which kind of scenario what timers will be used? Okay, now let us take an pulse width modulation. If I want to do an pulse width modulation, that is not possible with an watchdog timer or a basic timer or real time clock. Obviously the best option is timer B first. Why? Because means we can dynamically update the pulse width by having that latch up in a timer B mode. Okay, other than that one, we can go for a timer A also. It is going to be supported. If I want to do any pulse width modulation, I'm going for a timer B or a timer A. Then less regular outputs. Okay, it is not defined, only some cases we are going to be using on and capturing. You can take in some signal rising edge or falling edge that need to be recorded. The option is timer A or an B. Okay, input need to be sampled at regular interval, means any of our timer B is not going to be supported. We are going to use only a timer A. Then inputs need to be timed. Okay, at that time we can take a timer A or a timer B. Timed in the sense timing information you want to measure, that option is supported by timer A or B. Interaction with other peripheral. Suppose you want to communicate with an peripherals, always it is better to connect our capture compare channel pins through an internal resistor setting or doing. If we do that one, we don't need to restart our computer or an CPU so that the power will be saved. If you are connecting through an external wires, we need to turn off and we need to do it. It is going to consume. Suppose if I want to have an periodic software inputs interrupts, at that time we know that in a watchdog timer we can have an 8 dedicated intervals. If I go for a basic timer, from a counter 1 we can have an 4 dedicated intervals. Then from counter 2 I can have an 8 dedicated intervals. With the combination of those things I can get a lot of intervals. Then in a real time clock also I can set the timings for what timing I want to get. Anyhow, we can also get that through a timer A or a timer B also. Okay, less regular software interrupt means at that time we are going for a timer B or a timer A. Less regularly if I want to get an interrupts. Okay, this is about what timer where. Thank you for watching.